Long enough to cover the subject and short enough to keep it interesting. Welcome to Out of My League. I'm Nick Diaz. Remember when you were in school and you would, like, before, you know, like 2 weeks before the exam, you would try, like, really, really hard to study for that final exam at the end of the semester? You did everything you could. You had study buddies. You studied 2 weeks ahead of time. You went to every, you know, class review, final exam review. You had tutors. Whatever. You did everything you could, and you still didn't get a good grade in the class. And the reason why is because you sat around all semester, and you laid on your ass, and you did nothing. All semester long. You had a great game plan for studying for that exam, early and often. You did everything you could, but you still didn't get a good grade in the class. Because you paid for the sins of yesterday. You did all that fucking around all semester long, and it didn't matter how great the end result was for your game plan. You still didn't get a great grade in the class. LSU, their game plan against Mississippi State, was great. The coaching adjustments week to week are fantastic. This week, against Mississippi State, they ran a 3-2-6 defense, something they had never run before. But they made adjustments, and they got creative, and they were diverse, and they were unique. For every single week, especially against Mississippi State. We're going to win different ways every single week. That's what good coaching is. LSU dominated for 3.5 quarters against Mississippi State. LSU had fewer penalties. LSU had fewer mistakes. LSU won the turnover battle over Mississippi State. And LSU, currently in the Southeastern Conference, they lead the SEC in sacks, touchdown passes, touchdown receptions by a wide receiver, Kayshon Boutte, explosive plays by a wide receiver, Kayshon Boutte. Their linebacker, Damone Clark, leads the SEC in tackles. And their defensive end, B.J. Ojulari, leads the SEC individually in sacks. And you know why, despite all of that, LSU couldn't finish the game comfortably and still only won by 3 points? It's because LSU cannot run the football. Not because of the current offensive line coach is bad. Quite the contrary, Brad Davis is actually a very good offensive line coach. But because LSU is paying for the sins of recruiting bad offensive linemen. They are paying for the sins of not recruiting enough good offensive linemen. And they were not developing the good offensive linemen that they had for the past 2 or 3 years. And then in the middle of the offseason, you fire your bad offensive line coach for a better offensive line coach, but that offensive line coach is completely different and teaches a completely different technique and style than the previous offensive line coach. So then you started with a bad offensive line from ground zero in the middle of August. The reason why this was a 3-point win over Mississippi State is because LSU's defense got tired because the offense for LSU could not run the ball in the fourth quarter and put the game away. And so the defense stayed on the field longer, they got tired, and they gave up some cheap touchdowns at the end. Well, you know, we hired a better offensive line coach. We had a better game plan. We made fewer mistakes. The coaching staff was working really hard, getting better week to week. Our entire roster is loaded. Doesn't matter. Does not matter. Because this is the most well-constructed roster, top to bottom, at every single position, except the offensive line. In the entire Southeastern Conference, which makes it one of the best and deepest rosters in all of the country. But none of it matters because you have committed the cardinal sin of football. You can't run the ball. It's a tale as old as time. If you can't run the ball, you will not win consistently. Look around the country. You want to know what's wrong with Clemson? Why Clemson has just fallen off a cliff? Because they just forgot to develop their offensive line. Look, you don't have to be great at running the football. You can't be this bad and expect to win games consistently. You realize that Mike Leach ran the ball more times and for more yards than LSU did? Let me say that again. Mike Leach ran the ball more times and for more yards than LSU. Yeah, but Nick, LSU had a 3-man front. So did Mississippi State. They run a 3-man front. LSU has played UCLA, McNeese, Central Michigan, and Mississippi State, and they have not once ran the ball, not even come close to running the ball for 100 yards in any of those games. So what's going to happen when they play Florida, Ole Miss, Alabama, Arkansas? So you've heard the term complementary football, right? It's basically a nice way of saying that you are not one-dimensional. So, for example, LSU under Les Miles for years and years, they were not a complementary football team for the most part. Because what did Les Miles do on offense? He He ran the ball, but he couldn't pass on third and long when you got in those situations, which means you get quick three and outs, which means LSU's defense, as great as they were, as talented as they were, as deep as they were, they can't stay on the field that long. And then you all know the story. They would get tired in the fourth quarter, and then Alabama would pull away. And you would lose those games because you did not have a complementary football. You weren't balanced. And guess what? LSU, right now, that's what they are. They are not a complementary football team, except it's worse. Because LSU can't run the ball or pass block, which is the one thing they can do, is pass. I mean, how many guys on the LSU's offensive line have been put on their asses? Not just get beat on the edge. I mean, get put down on the ground, lying on their back against Mississippi State, Central Michigan, UCLA. Just get put on their back over and over and over again. LSU's passing offense is one of the best in the country, yet when they play better pass-rushing teams, they won't be able to properly execute that passing game because they can't pass block. And that will get exposed when you play better teams that are equally as talented as you are, which means in those complementary football key situations in third and long, hold the line of scrimmage for a long time so the quarterback can make the right throw. When it's fourth and short or third and short and you need a conversion, your offensive line can't get a push to keep the defense off the field, to keep the clock running. That will get you exposed against better football teams. If you can't run the ball in the fourth quarter, you will not put the game away and the other team will always have a chance. Now, having said all of this, I'm going to speak out of the other end of my mouth. I think LSU has a better chance to beat Auburn than they do Mississippi State, simply because of what I said last week, matchups. Auburn, who can run block better than LSU, is very, very one-dimensional. Except it's not on purpose, like Mississippi State, who chooses to be one-dimensional. Auburn does not have a passing game simply because they're incapable of having a passing game, and that's playing right into the LSU's defensive strengths. Auburn's defense gives up bad plays in the passing game. LSU passes the ball better than, statistically, almost anyone in the Southeastern Conference. And if Auburn gets behind in this game, coming up, like Mississippi State did, they can't come back like State did, because their passing game is one of the worst in the Southeastern Conference. If you're going to play from behind, you better have an efficient passing game. Auburn does not. So do I feel better about LSU every single week I see them? Yeah, I would say I do. Every week I feel a little bit better. Do I feel better about their coaching staff for LSU? Yes. I've actually been more impressed every single game by the coaching staff and the new coordinators. Do I think if LSU played UCLA today, do I think they would win? No, maybe so. Does my prediction from last week, where I predict that LSU will end 7-5 at the end of the season, does that change? The magic little number that will get Coach O fired? Nope. It still stays the same. Nothing LSU has done last week or the week before in their wins has made me feel any better about them not going 7-5 or better than 7-5. You have a good matchup coming up between Auburn and Kentucky, but none of that will matter for LSU. Because all that work that Coach O and his staff are putting in each and every week is just delaying the inevitable. Because you are paying for the sins of yesterday with that offensive line. Thanks for listening to Out of My League. If you like what you heard, be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Or follow me on Twitter and Facebook in the description link below.